Hi everyone, welcome to my show and share. It's Jav here from Medieval Mirage and I'm coming to you with the tutorial on resizing papers. And here before you, you've got a 10x7 or when folded 5x7, and it's all about how to enlarge or reduce these papers without distorting it and still retaining good quality. So to those that are new here, I really appreciate your visit. And to my subscribers, thanks so much for your support. It means a lot. And to all, a warm welcome to everyone. Okay, what we're going to do is just have a look at this image that I have here. Now, for those of you that like these type of papers, I'll have the link listed below. It's from my medieval fragments collection. I wanted to show you here that some of my papers in my shop are 10x7 or when folded 5x7. So I want to show you how to do the way that I prefer to do the resizing. So we can use our software editing program, and you can use whatever software editing program you have to do this. Now, what we're going to do first of all is we're going to open up and create some new blank files. Okay, so the first one I'm going to start off with is A4. Which is the paper preference for myself. We're going to go image, rotate, left. I'm also going to do another one, and I might do it a little bit differently. I'm going to show you another thing you can do. Okay, we're going to go US letter size. Okay, US. I'm going to come back and I'll show you a really fast way of doing this. I'm going to go back with my a smaller size now. This is A6. And I'm going to do another one. I'm going to go into photo. I'm going to do 4x6. So what I've done is I've, you know, chosen that one. Okay. File up. What I wanted to show you is because we need these two images down here, you know, as landscape, you just click on these and just go left, and both of them have turned left. So in your box, it gives you that option. All right, so we're going to also make two more. So I want to show you, okay, international paper A3. And file, we'll just do that one now, file, new blank. And then we're going to use something that's a little bit different. And we're going to do 12 by 12. Okay. All right, let's get our image in. Let's open. All right. Right, so we have our image here, and the whole purpose of this tutorial, and there's many other ways I'm sure of doing this, but the preferred method that I like is this, that I'll show you today. Of course you have a lot more options when you're going to print your image, but I wanted to show you the way that I prefer to do it. Okay, so all I do is I go into my marquee tool. And I very carefully grab it this way. Just make sure I'm within the parameters. Okay, so I'm now going to copy that. This now means that it's going to be on our clipboard and we can continue pasting without having to go back to this image. Okay, so I'm going to show you now what happens in A4. Okay, so in A4 we have pasted it in, and all we do is So we're going to just go with our move tool. I apologize. That's our move tool. I'll just do that again. Okay, so it was edit, paste. There's our picture. And now I'm going into the move tool. And I'm going to click it. And you'll see there's these little arrows. Well, we don't want it this way. We want it to be where it's going in a diagonal. direction. Okay, so I'm going to commit, and with my keyboard I'm just using my arrows to just move it across, and then I'm just going to use that to just go up a little bit and down a little bit. Click, and there you go. Your paper has just been resized. And now you might be thinking, but oh my goodness, you've stretched it out too much. Well, the thing is, when I create my papers, they're actually either A4 or US letter size to begin with, and they're high resolution. By moving them very carefully in either direction, we're not distorting this picture, nor are we going beyond its parameters of where the quality of the paper is going to get lost. It doesn't. I print out my papers like this myself, and the quality is fine for myself. You can experiment by all means, but the difference between this, and it's still kept within the proportions and parameters of the actual original image. This is where you run into trouble. Okay, say now you would love it if you could use this paper, which is only, you know, made for this dimension. If you wanted to do it as a 12 by 12, well, really, this is the best you could do. Because now, if you go like this, not only is that harmful and the quality won't be good when you print it out, it's really distorted it from its original. I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so let's duplicate that so that we'll have a copy underneath. So, be able to see the difference. Okay, so this is looking really weird. See, it's no longer looking like the original, and you can tell that there's something wrong with this. So this is what I'm meaning. We don't, when we are getting to do this, we're not stretching it beyond its parameters. We're still within its shape. We are just enlarging it without distorting it. And because it's 300 high resolution, the quality will still be good. Whereas the quality won't be good with this. Even with the A3, I wouldn't push my luck with that. It's still, because it's going way beyond the original perimeters to a massive extent. It's not distorted, but now we're really pushing our luck as to how good the quality will be. So it could start affecting that. So personally, when I'm doing these resizing, I'm not going to A3 or 12 by 12s or a really weird shape. I'm trying really hard to keep just within the perimeters of the original. So That's what I mean by perimeters of the original image. Now, US letter size is a little bit different to A4 and even the 10 by 7. So this is where it can get a little bit tricky, but let's see what we can do. So let's now move it up. See, I don't use US letter paper size, so I don't really run into these problems, but I've got okay, so this is how I would do it if I was using US letter. Okay, and now I will just very gently go in this way and this way. Okay, so that's one way you can resize your US letter. Just be mindful that there's a little bit of a gap showing, so I'm using my arrow tool on my keyboard just to bring it down so that it works. I'll do this again for you. Okay, so once again, we're just very hang on, let me do that again, sorry. Moving it that way. So we're still keeping within the parameters. So you could end up just using it like this, but obviously it's still smaller. I mean, if you wanted it to be this size, and what size is that? Let's have a look what size this is now. Okay, so this is 11 by 7.693 inches. You might want it that size, but if you wanted it to be the full size, you could go like this, but it is cutting off quite a lot of your image. I mean, you could use your little move tool or your arrow on your keyboard and go like that, and use it like that. But the other way, as I was showing you before, is you can just take that like this, and it's really not distorting the paper as much as it would, say, as it was in the 12 by 12, or, in the 12 by 12, because it's still keeping within the original parameters. So let's just do copy and paste. Okay. So when you look at the difference, I'll put that underneath there now. It's not that bad, is it? Okay. So those are those ones with the enlarging. So if you need to watch this again, please replay it until you get the gist of it. Okay, so now let's resize with the small. So I've just copied, I've just done here, I've just pasted. Now obviously this is really big, so we're using our move tool to get it to the size it's supposed to be. Alright, so once again, it's, you know, you might prefer it to be that size there, but all I need to do is just go like that, and it still is keeping the original proportions of how this was designed, and there's not much extension so that you lose quality. The quality will stay the same because it's a high resolution image, and it's not like you're stretching it beyond its limits and perimeters. And this is our 4x6, so I'll do a copy and paste. There we go. I'll just get it to there. Okay. And that's like that. Alright, so now you've got this. Now this size here is that's 5.7 and 4. You know, you might prefer it the size. Well, then you can print it out on that size, but you would have that, you know, white bit that it cuts off with. So once again, what we would do is we're going to go back out this way, okay, and then we bring it down. Just, yeah, so see, it's still keeping it within its perimeters, but it's the way you go about doing it. So I'll show that to you again. Okay, so repaste. Okay, so we got it to there. How do we fix that? Remember, very carefully go this way. And then we come down. And there you go. So you've still got the entire image. You're working within its perimeters and it hasn't distorted it dramatically so that it looks weird. So, I hope this has been of help to you, everyone. I really do appreciate your company. If this was helpful and you would like to see more of these tutorials, your support in subscribing would be immensely valued and appreciated by me. So do consider subscribing, because I endeavour to have more of these type of tutorials, lots more coming. They're just waiting in the wings to be uploaded, but I do appreciate having you with me today, and I'll see you around. Take care till then. Thank you, everyone. Bye.